for the period we've seen Parliament act, what has that agenda been? I mean, VAT shoots up. But everything negative is what they are legislating on. And the question Kenyans ought to be asking is, if you look at the court side, what are these measures you are taking that can you know, confirm that really you are pro-people and pro-poor? He talked about our walking from Parliament. At times, it is something that can cause you to walk. If you remember the day you were going for recess, somebody reported Kaluma was nearly crying. When you see people dealing with serious laws to underpin proper governance of the country, just shouting without even giving a second thought at what they are, you feel so bad at times. Sometimes it is so ridiculous. You can only provoke their conscience by telling them, then gentlemen, being it alone will not be a party to it. That is why we walk, not that we can't debate or we don't debate. In fact, you know, Cobb side, as the best debaters we have around, he has some affiliation with our party by history. But I wanted to say one thing, that there is a reason as to why the Constitution says the security apparatus of the nation should reflect the ethnic and regional diversity of the country. There is a good reason as to why the Constitution itself says that even when you are recruiting members of the forces, you have to do it at every district across the country. We cannot have that system. Then you have a structure which is operating by the command at the top, being led at the top by one or two ethnic formations. I mean, we need an overhaul of the security apparatus.
Why haven't you gone to court to challenge that?
It is not the work of a parliamentarian to go to court. It is, of course, the work of other Kenyans. Parliamentarians legislate. And, of course, we are doing everything. My brother will tell you, I have a motion on the floor of parliament, which has been delayed due, of course, to the problems on their side and what they mean, that they know it would portend. But I'm suggesting that recruitment of the police and the recruitment of the military now takes place at the level of each and every constituency in the country. Because we have a problem.
It has always been like that.
No, it has never been like that. I can tell you that they say district, but district loose, and if you remember, like the northern frontier, what they know are not the security apparatus. They know police reservists. That's what they are crying for. Why? Because their chances are taken by people in the force up in Nairobi and are shared to their cronies around here. We want a system where, as a member of parliament, I can go to Homa Bay during recruitment and say, well, we had an allocation of 10 people to the military who have been taken, and I can really, as the representative of the people, confirm they came from my constituency, and then it happens across. We need to overhaul the security apparatus.
Let me deal with the question of numbers and whether Jubilee won or not, didn't win. In today's newspaper, when you had a meeting in Kisumu, there was a private meeting, some lodge in Kisumu. One of the strategies that you laid, according to today's paper, is that you said in Western Kenya, Nyanza, and the coast, you are going to ensure that everybody who is 18 years will be registered get an ID. That's a strategy to try and beat the Jubilee. Isn't that an animation that the reason why you won is because of that?
No, not at all.
It is
the argument is right, but it is not well contextualized. Mm-hmm. You know, for even the Jubilee side to continue to win if they won, which I deny, in areas where they are supported, the people who can vote continue being, readying themselves to be able to participate.
This will happen
in cord areas, this will happen in Jubilee areas and others. So the idea that you tell your membership or your voting, zones that really take more votes. I mean, what did Obama do?
That is what we're saying. You failed to do.
No, we did it.
And that's why you lost.
You know, that is the myth being created to justify this rigging.
They slept on the job.
No. Exactly. I mean, we voted. I mean, that is the myth being created.
Because they had assumed that they were going to win anyway. They had already been declared the winners. We were told we have no chance of winning. We did our homework. We went to the grassroots. We organized. We brought our numbers together. And after all, democracy is about a number. The word tyranny of numbers is a misnomer, because at the end of the day, democracy is about numbers. We organized our people. We brought them to the voting booths, and they voted. And this is the reality.
And that's what they are realizing today.
Yes.
That's what you are writing today.
That is not true. Let me tell you. This is the myth they have always placed before Kenyans to justify their illegitimate power. The fact of the matter is that if you looked at how, you know, people registered to vote in the last elections across the country, I mean, across the country, every area, there was the upping of numbers. People took votes. What we are saying is that if you go to some areas and you find they have exhausted, every Kenyan who is capable of voting, always be ready to vote. Have your identification document, have your voting card. It is not to say they won. I've told you, and this is something I think I want to repeat for the last time. I'm not getting this from nowhere. My brother Yusuf does not sit in Justice and Legal Affairs Committee.
I don't need to sit in that committee to know that we won the elections.
I wish he spoke with the membership of Jubilee in the committee to confirm how the results were doctored. In fact, even the chair will tell him there is a big problem. Even his votes were slashed down to try to bring them down.
Let me say that, in fact, Jubilee does not require legitimacy from court. Jubilee was elected by the overwhelming majority of the Kenyan people.
That's what you assume.
Yeah, we don't assume. We won. We won clearly, fairly, in a highly contested election. And therefore, our legitimacy is based, our mandate is based on the Kenyan people.
That's what I'm challenging him to give us, that document
exactly.
that he says he has.
Can we
there
come
is
back
no
tomorrow?
Such a document. There
I
is
know,
no
I
such
have
a
it. Can we come tomorrow? I mean, do it
there
for Kenyans.
There is no such a document.
No,
it will have long appeared
in the
media.
I want us to come back here with my brother tomorrow with a document from IEBC.
Please don't be destroyed by your own propaganda. Don't believe in your own propaganda. Don't believe in your own propaganda.
Or why don't you allow them to permit IEBC?
This is a party that is sinking in the weight of its own, believing in its own propaganda.
Not at all.
It's sinking.
Not at all.
Yes.
We are not sinking. I mean, we are the most popular party. There is an issue that they said we are few in Parliament. And that
to
Yusuf confirms that we lost elections.
And the Senate.
I can tell you what happened.
Look at the Senate as well.
I can tell you what happened. And I wish you would listen to this because it is something that is going to hit you on the face come next elections whenever they are held. Because to us, they can be held any time, even before 2017.
How?
Anything can happen. I mean, this government is dead. I mean, this government is dysfunctional.
You cannot say that.
You need to be in Kenya to know this government is as good as non-existent.
Which part of Kenya do you come from?
I come from Nairobi.
You must be living in a you must be living in a lonely island somewhere in the Indian Ocean.
No, Yusuf, what is a government?
I think you live on a lonely island. But this is what I was just warning you about, honorable member, is that when you internalize your own propaganda and you believe in what you want to believe, and you believe in fake conspiracy theories that the Kenyan Defense Force was involved, the IEBC was involved, the judiciary is involved, you know, all these national institutions that we have taken years to build, and you contradict them. It means you are now a lonely...
Has he read the decision which came from the Supreme Court?
A lonely decision, a lonely
Everybody
issue.
Everybody has. It's
you know, have you read it? Can you follow that decision from the head to the tail?
But what was the final?
Is running from it.
What was the final conclusion?
The Chief Justice is running from it.
Did they read it in public as cases are read? I mean, did you see the mood of the Chief Justice even the day was to render the decision?
What mood was that?
The media was given 1 minute to photograph people. Did they take a minute, 15 seconds, get out? I mean, did you see? I mean, I'm a lawyer.
But what is their final conclusion?
Read the decision.
What was their final conclusion?
The judiciary has to be reformed. IEBC has to be reformed.
Because you lost.
The security apparatus has to be reformed. Not that we may win, but for us to have a fair electoral democratic processes in Kenya going forward.
Which court must win?
No, I'm not saying court must win. It is my wish that our party wins.
Just a question, looking at the relationship between court and Jubilee, there have been many claims and blames on Jubilee that the Jubilee government is actually targeting court from seeking to dissolve some of the counties that are...
Yes.
You know, ODM or cord turfs.
But that is in the figment of the imagination of this conspiracy-minded, conspiracy-focused opposition party.
The deputy president did not speak to it.
The deputy president made a statement to warn the activities of the counties, which as the deputy president of the Republic of Kenya he's entitled to. He is, after all, the next in command. If there is insecurity problems in one part of a country, surely the president and the deputy president have the right to intervene and take action to defend and protect the rights of Kenyan people.
Them.
Yes.
He called them to...
He called them
yes, and he has resolved. Yes, which accord could not... Let me finish. I've allowed you... Let me answer the question. Mm-hmm. Is that what CORD needs to do, for example, in Parliament, which they're not doing at the moment, is that they're criticising the Speaker, they're criticising the Jubilee majority. There is absolutely nothing they can do about the Jubilee majority because this is a majority that has been elected by the Kenyan people. But what they can do is sit down with the leadership of Jubilee and the Speaker to be able to work out arrangements in which they can be effective in Parliament and present issues in Parliament that are legitimate as an opposition party. Okay. But what they have done, as Honourable Kaluma would confirm, is that they have rejected. They have said the Speaker is not our Speaker.
No, that is not
we
true.
We are not. I mean that you is know, he true. Favors the majority, which no,
that
he doesn't.
That is not true.
Yes.
That is not
true. I think you need to confirm that here, that you accept that our Speaker.
I'm saying that the Speaker, in a number of occasions, yes. and this is for the nation to watch because parliamentary proceedings are broadcast live. Huh? The fact of the matter is that we want the Speaker to rise to national leadership. And remember that after election, whether he came through the CORD side or Jubilee, is now a Speaker of the entire National Assembly, and he has to command the confidence of the entire National Assembly. The fact of the matter, and I can say this without blinking an eye, is that we wish Honorable Justice Muturi can perform better than he is performing currently. This is patently biased to the minority
side. It is unfair. The Speaker is not here for him to make a serious accusation.
But let me address the issue of the county government. You know, the...